of all, I congratulate Oric, Dr. Naveed Ahsan, and his team for organizing this 8th summit in Punjab University. Congratulations to UMT for having this long journey with Punjab University and with the other institutions. In reality, the role of the universities, what is the role of the universities? The first is to create the knowledge. It is the prime objective of the universities. That is why this innovation summit or such type of research activities are held in the universities. The innovation is research comes from the universities. Generation of knowledge has to come from the universities. This is the prime role of the universities, which universities have, I think, somehow neglected this important area. The university used to deliver the knowledge, transfer the knowledge. It was like a colleges. Up to 2002, before the creation of Higher Education Commission, the universities were simply a colleges and delivering the lecture in the classrooms. I can remember, I joined the universities in late 80s. The situation sometimes came when there was no money to give the salary to the teachers. And we were getting the overdraft from the banks. But in 2002, the situation immediately changed. The Higher Education Commission was established, and that then funding was coming. And I think the government realized that without the higher education, you cannot transform the society. And I think that was the decision which actually transformed the teaching institutions into research and teaching institutions. I was mentioning that this is the prime role of the university. If the people, I'm very pleased that I'm addressing the researchers of the community, researcher, industry, industrial sector, private and public sector. The researcher which has to, which are innovating something. The innovation is coming from there. But one thing which I will request to all of you, that instead of doing the basic research, which my colleagues, the industrial sector, the UMT fellow, Sherwani Saab, he was also stressing that we should have the applied research, the research which is required for our country. Otherwise, the basic research, cut paste, having some ideas, transforming that into some theoretical work, I think that is, of course, it has got its own importance, the basic research. But what is required for our country, it is the applied research. We are doing the research. My faculty members are doing the research. But what is the impact on the society? This is important. What the, again, one of my colleagues was mentioning how much amount we are putting, the funds we are putting on the research and development. No doubt there should be expectations from the society, from the leadership, from the top management of the country that universities should perform. But very if small figure, my one of my university from where I graduated, 30,000 students, one of the university, and its ranking is about 80. 90, because it varies. And its budget is equal, more than 187 universities of our country. This one university, and the budget of one university is more than 187 universities of the Pakistan. And the budget of Cambridge University is double than that of the University of Leeds. Harvard University budget is double than the budget of the Cambridge University. So when you are funding something, giving the autonomy, giving the research funding to the institutions, of course the results are coming. But one thing what we must remember, okay, these are the figures where my academia, my industrialists, they play with these figures. One important thing is the persons who are sitting over here and those who are studying in higher education institutions, they are not the Pakistani citizen. Now today in this global village, you are the international citizen. Even sitting in this camp, you can compete at any level in the higher education sector, in higher education institutions, in any of the industry in the world. But we must revisit our policies. We must revisit our research activities. My friend Fahim, colleague from the Lahore Chamber, he was mentioning about Pakistan Railway, PTV, and such other organizations. I think what the government should do, how much money government has spent on the Pakistan Railway, and why the results have not come? How much fund has been given to the PIA? What are the results from there? Just look into the Pakistan Telecommunication Company. Where are the results? And you were mentioning something about the PTV. Some are the services sector, which I mentioned. But some are the manufacturing sector. Some for the manufacturing sector, they must compete. I was talking to one of the textile industry. He said there is a ban on our industry. We cannot export the yarn. And he said, for example, I think 30 to 35% there was a profit to one industry if they were exporting the yarn at the international level. But the government plea was that if this gray yarn is being exported, then there will be no value addition. Therefore, this yarn should be processed and more export or the value addition should come and more export money should be coming to the country. But it is, remember, okay, you can stop the export by putting some bans on the sugar or on the yarn or other such materials, on the raw materials or on the product. But it is the competition age. You will not be able to stop next 5-10 years. It is an open market. If I am getting, for example, my faculty member, there are examples, you know it well. Some of our faculty members from the Punjab University, sitting in Punjab University, they have competed in the higher education institution and they have been selected and they have left the Punjab University. Why they should stay? If the higher education institutions are not on the market based, they are not competing, why one will stay at 200,000 salary in one of the institutions, whereas he is getting 500,000, the junior level position in the Saudi Arabia. It is double in the developed country like UK. Therefore, I think we, the Pakistani, we have to realize, ye funding se abhi baat ho rahi thi. Okay, we are getting the donations, we are getting the loans from abroad, and we are feeding the higher education institutions or any other government sector. Up to what extent? We have to work hard. It is this house, the researchers who are sitting here, they are responsible. What problems the community is facing, how we have to pull out our society from these problems. If we are doing the research, my students are doing the research, just for passing that exam, that getting that degree, getting the promotions, if this is the objective, that has been achieved. But now, all the researchers, all the faculty members, what is the objective of the research? What is the objective of the task which we are doing? What is its impact on the society? This was the prime objective of the higher education institutions. Creation of knowledge through the research, and that will lead to the innovation. And secondly, when knowledge is being created, then you have to transfer that knowledge. And the third one is, again, the ethics, moral values, which the universities or the teachers should inculcate to the students. I think this is the time you have seen, in this, especially in the last couple of weeks, when Pakistan was facing problem with India. Mujhe kisi ne kaha ke, yaar dekhe kisi ke bayan nahi aaya, kisi international player ka. Pakistan, maine kaha nahi aana chahiye, Pakistan ko apne paon ke upar, ye dikhana chahiye ke we are the nation. And they have showed it. Pakistan, wo ab us cheezon se nikal gaya hai. Aap kahein ke ye falan cheez ho jayegi, kuch nahi hota Pakistan ko. Abhi mera colleague keh rahe the, Fahim, jitna opportunities Pakistan mein available hain, India mein ek PhD PN ki position ke liye apply karta hai. Aapka yahan pe PhD degree holder, assistant professor ki position pe main usko dhoond raha hota hun ke main use induct kar. Aap Britain ko dekh lein, assistant lecture, PhD ki degree hasil karta hai, postdoc karta hai, dusri postdoc karta hai, uske baad lecturer ki position ja ke milti hai usse. Aur wo bhi lucky hai jisko lecturer ki position milti, lekin nahi milti. Aapke paas opportunities hi opportunities hai. Lekin agar hum ye sochein ke hame koi aur mulk aake system bana ke dega, hame koi aur mulk aake hamare liye research aake karega, nahi, aisa nahi hoga. ये तो बहरहाल आज आप काम करें या कल आप अपने आप को चेंज करें, काम तो बहरहाल आपको करना है. अपॉर्चुनिटीज इस मुल्क में जितनी हैं और किसी मुल्क में नहीं है, आई एग्री विद दैट, लेकिन वी हैव टू वर्क हार्ड. इसके बगैर काम नहीं चलेगा. मुझे एक शर्ट अगर लेट से 500 रुपए की मिलती है, मैं 1500 रुपए वाली शर्ट क्यों लूंगा? एंड दैट शर्ट इज अवेलेबल इन द मार्केट. ये कंपिटिशन है. होके ये पॉसिबल है कि मैं इंडिया की शर्ट ना खरीदूं, लेकिन मैं ये पॉसिबल है वो 500 रुपए की शर्ट मैं श्रीलंका की खरीद लूंगा, मैं वो नेपाल की खरीद लूंगा, मैं 1500 रुपए की वो पाकिस्तानी शर्ट नहीं करूं खरीदूंगा. क्योंकि अगेन इट इज द कंपटीशन. और अगर इसका सोल्यूशन ये हाउस जो हाईली क्वालिफाइड है, अगर ये मुझे ये प्रपोज नहीं करता उसका सोल्यूशन, ये then it is the unfortunate for the Pakistan. Bahrhal solution universities ne dena hai. Kisi bhi problem ka solution, that has to come from the universities. Aap apne role ko, is cheez ko accept karein ya na karein, ye aapka role hai. Ek civilized citizen dena to the society, ye aapka role hai. Aapne solution provide karna to the society, ye aapka role hai. एक अच्छी जनरेशन आपने आगे पाकिस्तान को देना, ये आपका रोल है. अगर आप इस रोल से, मैं बाज़ औकात फील करता हूँ, मेरा टीचर ने क्लास पढ़ाई है और उसके बाद जो है ना वो ऐसे जा रहा है, ये सो जेंटल एंड ये सो बिजी इन द रिसर्च. एक कोई अगर ऐसी चीज़ हो रही है वो उससे बादर ही नहीं करता. यानी ये मेरा बच्चा है, मैं इसको ये ठीक हालत में नहीं बैठा, ये क्लास में नहीं आ रहा, मैं इसको बताऊँ कि क्यों नहीं क्लास में तू आया, ये आपका रोल है. हम कहते हैं कि नहीं, मैंने क्लास पढ़ाई थी, अच्छा लेक्चर मैंने डिलीवर किया है, 2 घंटे की मैंने क्लास पढ़ाई, इसके बाद दैट इज ओवर. नहीं, आप अपनी पोजीशंस को रियलाइज करें. आपका जो रोल है, इट इज ए रोल मॉडल. हर एक का काम नहीं है कि वो टीचर बने, वो रिसर्चर बने. ये एक रोल मॉडल आपको होना चाहिए इन ऑल एस्पेक्ट्स, नॉलेज वाइज, मॉरल वाइज, फिनेंशियली, हर लिहाज से. आपको रिसर्चर हैं, इंटेलेक्चुअल प्रॉपर्टी की बात हुई, यस, यू हैव टू बी फेयर विद योर रिसर्च. आपको हर लिहाज से, रिसर्च में, टीचिंग में, इनोवेशन में, आपको यू हैव टू बी द रोल मॉडल. और आपने उसको जो आपके आपके स्कोप्स डिफाइन किए गए हैं, अगर अभी बात हुई कि पैसे कितना मिलते हैं रिसर्च में, पाकिस्तान के रिसर्च की कोई फंडिंग नहीं. मैं बड़ी मुश्किल से 35% मैं बजट अपना यूनिवर्सिटीज़ का, दैट इज़ फ्रॉम द गवर्नमेंट साइड, 65 इज़ कमिंग फ्रॉम माय ओन रिसोर्सेज. और बड़ी मुश्किल से हम सैलरीज देते हैं, लेकिन इसके बावजूद इसका मेरे पास आंसर नहीं है. अगर मैं आपसे कहूं कि आप मेरे से पूछें कि कैसे, हाउ जस्टिफाई यू आर, आपका लॉजिक क्या है, मेरे पास लॉजिक नहीं है. लेकिन मेरे पास जो भी रिसर्च प्रपोजल्स आई, मैंने इनकार नहीं किया, चाहे मेरे पास ये पंजाब यूनिवर्सिटी थी, मेरे पास नेशनल टेक्सटाइल यूनिवर्सिटी के अगर कोई लोग बैठे हैं वो, चाहे मैं यूईटी टेक्सला में था, मैंने कहा रिसर्च के हवाले से जो आप मेरे पास प्रपोजल भेजेंगे आई विल अप्रूव दैट। और उसमें अल्लाह सुबहाना ताला ने ऐसी बरकत दी है कि चाहे इन तीनों इंस्टीट्यूशंस का मैंने आपके साथ शेयर किया, और आज भी मेरे कोलीग्स वहाँ पे, मैं 60,000 पर मंथ पीएचडी के स्टूडेंट को स्कॉलरशिप देता था। ये मैंने इनोवेट किया कि नहीं, जो बच्चा एमफिल या पीएचडी करने आए, एमफिल के स्टूडेंट को 30,000 पे करता था, पीएचडी के स्टूडेंट को 60,000 पे करता था। और उसके बाद कुछ प्राइवेट इंस्टीट्यूशंस ने इसको अडॉप्ट किया, और उसकी रीज़न ये थी कि जो आदमी मेरे पास एमफिल और पीएचडी करने आए, लेकिन उसके लिए शर्त थी कि इतना मेरा वो मुझे शो करेगा कि उसके रिसर्च का क्या इम्पैक्ट आया है। तो इसलिए मेरा व्हाट आई विल हम्बली रिक्वेस्ट यू, मेरा ख्याल हो सक मैंने शायद डेविएट किया हो आज की उसमें, लेकिन क्योंकि जो इस वक्त हाउस मेरे पास अवेलेबल है, ए गुड मिक्स फ्रॉम ऑल ओवर द प्रोविंसेस, फ्रॉम द ऑल द यूनिवर्सिटीज ऑफ द कंट्री, पब्लिक एंड प्राइवेट यूनिवर्सिटीज, दोज हु आर द लीडर्स इन द रिसर्च, प्लीज डू द रिसर्च विच हैज गॉट द इम्पैक्ट ऑन द सोसाइटी, अदरवाइज इसका कोई फायदा, यू हैव वेस्टेड द टाइम, यू हैव वेस्टेड द मनी, यू हैव द वेस्टेड द टाइम ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स, इसका कोई फायदा नहीं। लेकिन आई होप जो मैंने एक सरसरी सा आई हैव विजिटेड द आई हैव सीन सम स्टार्स द प्रोडक्ट्स विच हैव बीन डिस्प्लेड, आई डू होप दे हैव द इम्पैक्ट ऑन द स्टेक होल्डर्स, एंड वी शुड हैव क्लोज लाइजान विद द इंडस्ट्रियल सेक्टर। व्हाट वी आर प्रोड्यूसिंग दैट वॉज अनफॉर्चुनेट, that I was making the product and the customer was not familiar with the product, what it is, what is the requirement of the industry. I am producing a product for the industry and industry is not aware of, I am not aware of what the industry needs. Therefore, this gap should be minimized. I am very pleased, congratulations to Naveed for bringing the industry, the private sector, the public sector in this beautiful campus, and I do hope such activities inshallah will continue in the future as well, and all the resources whatever are required for the research purposes in the Punjab University inshallah we will I will provide, and we will support all such activities in the all the private sector, in the industrial sector. Thank you very much. Thanks to the Navy who have come from Karachi and they have participated. And inshallah, with these integrated efforts, we will uplift, inshallah, we will make Pakistan a great nation. And we have to make it. Aap bachchon ke liye, apne bachchon ke liye ghar bana ke jaate hain, ke mera beta jo hai na, mere bachche, ek achhe ghar mein rahe. Aap isko bhi sochein ke ek achha Pakistan hum deke jayein. Aur ye hamara role hai, wagna tareekh हमें नहीं माफ करेगी जो इस हाल में बैठे हैं। अगर आप लोग इस चीज को रियलाइज नहीं करते, जो इतना पढ़ा लिखा 1,000 में आप एक हैं, 1,000 में आप एक हैं, अगर आप रियलाइज नहीं करते कि मैंने पाकिस्तान को कैसा बनाना है, अपने घर को कैसा बनाना है, मेरे घर की क्या जरूरियात हैं, फिर आप बी श्योर कि कोई और मुल्क आके आपको घर की जरूरियात को देखने के लिए कि इनके घर की ये जरूरत है और मैं इनको ये चीजें प्रोवाइड करूं, ऐसा कभी नहीं होगा। आप बेशक सोए रहे, लेकिन हमने इसको एक बड़ा अच्छा मुल्क, एक ग्रेट नेशन इंशाल्लाह ये बन चुका है, इसको हमने और पीक पे लेके जाना है इंशाल्लाह। गॉड ब्लेस यू ऑल, थैंक यू वेरी मच।
बहुत शुक्रिया मोहतरम वाइस चांसलर प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर नियाज अहमद साहब।